You're watching CRE Radio and TV. Today's video is with Stuart Goldstein discussing collateralized loan obligations at CLOs, and he's going to be answering the questions as to where we are on the lending cycle in terms of lending standards and what does the future look like for the CRE lending business. This was filmed at the CREFC West Coast Summit 2018. I'm your host and founder, Howard F. Klein. We'd like to thank our sponsors, Crescent Capital Strategies, and the law firm of Schulte, Roth, and Zabel.
Is a CLO. I used to know it as a chief legal officer, but I don't think that's what you expect a CLO to mean.
Well, for our purposes, it's a collateralized loan obligation. And what it means is that we're issuing securities that are backed with the primary collateral being loans. In this case, being commercial real estate loans. Sure. I think what's on everybody's mind is where are we in the cycle? You know, where are we in terms of lending standards? What's the future of the business, and where are the loans going to come from? In any credit cycle, and we saw this whether it was pre-credit crisis or post-credit crisis, you start at one place, which tends to be a lower leverage, more senior position, and as the cycle goes on, you tend to go deeper into the capital stack and deeper into the risk profile. So the question really for me, and I'm very interested to see where the CREFC members are, is where are we and what's the appetite? What's the appetite on the lending side and what's the appetite on the investing side?
Do you have any opinions or thoughts or a crystal ball where we are and where we're going to be?
Well, you know, this product that we're talking about, the commercial real estate CLOs, tends to be a more transitional loan product, which is probably a little farther out on in the cycle. We didn't see it as a big product right after the credit crisis. So that would mean that we're starting to do different things. Right, looking at smaller properties, more developmental properties. So I think we're getting a little longer in the cycle, but I still feel like there's a lot of runway there to go.
Does it make any difference what type of property we're talking about?
Oh, yeah, most definitely. I mean, the property type is what's going to drive, in a lot of respects, what the risk profile is for the loan. How much cash flow do you have? How much cash flow will you have? What does it take to operate the property? Who's capable of operating the property? I mean, you've seen now the transition in society, not just commercial real estate, over retail. Right, and what the things that we took for granted in terms of neighborhood malls and the types of stores that would be neighborhood malls, or even the way grocery stores deliver food or are frequented, change based on e-commerce and things like Amazon and the delivery systems. That effect on a property type can't be ignored. Where we are in homeownership versus multifamily is another significant driver, and so those things really do drive the types of properties and the investment decisions that people are making.